What is going on, buddy? Welcome back to All Things Film. Today I'm here to talk about the first half of The Walking Dead Season 9 because the episode titles have been revealed for the first half of Season 9. On top of that, we also got the writer and the director of each episode, so that is very exciting and I want to talk about that in today's video. Before I do begin, however, if you are a fan of The Walking Dead, be sure to hit the subscribe button for daily Walking Dead videos and I guess a general spoiler warning in case you haven't been caught up with The Walking Dead. But other than that, let's get started. Let's begin with Episode 1. And the title is A New Beginning. That is the most perfect title you could give to the beginning of A New Beginning, because that's exactly what episode 1 is going to be. You know, it's going to pick up about 18 months after the events of All Out War. All the communities are going to be rebuilding, working together, and it's literally a new beginning. So that is a perfect title, and you know, it definitely fits what we're going to be seeing in episode 1. I'm very excited for, and the writer is Angela Kang, who is also the new showrunner, as we know. So it makes sense why she would want to start off, you know, this season for us. And then the director is Greg Nicotero, which again, he usually directs the big episodes, like the premieres, the mid-season premieres, mid-season finales, you know, the finales for the season. So he directs the big episodes. So episode 1, I love the title, like a really great title. So episode 1 is titled A New Beginning. Moving on to episode 2, and that is titled The Bridge. Now this episode, I believe, is going to focus on the bridge that we've been seeing in the trailers. They've been really focusing on this bridge that the Saviors and some of the Alexandrians and a bunch of people from every community, they've been working on connecting this bridge. Now, we have never really seen this bridge before, so I believe the reason they're probably rebuilding it is because it, you know, it's probably going to be connecting the communities or some making some sort of shortcut. But the bridge has really been, you know, focused a lot on the trailers and stuff. A lot of people also believe this could be a bridge that's connecting, you know, our people to maybe the Whispers and their group. I mean, that could definitely be a theory that could, you know, come true. But the bridge is definitely going to be, it's a good title because it definitely fits what's going to be happening in season 9. Now, the writer for this episode is David Leslie Johnson, who is, you know, he's a pretty well-known writer for the show. He's been writing since season 2. He wrote episodes like Swear, Hostiles and Calamities, How's It Gotta Be. He writes a lot of episodes for The Walking Dead. So he's a pretty well-known writer, and the director is Daisy Mayer, and she has directed, this is going to be her first episode directing for The Walking Dead, but she did direct an episode of Fear the Walking Dead this season, actually season 4. She directed Just in Case, which was the 6th episode, so she's new to The Walking Dead, but she has directed Fear the Walking Dead episode. So episode 2 of season 9 is titled The Bridge. So episode 3 is titled Warning Signs, and this is something that also fits that what we've been seeing in the trailer. We saw this thing at the sanctuary that said Savior save us, we are still Negan. And then actually a more clear shot of a warning sign is this one right here, what says Final Warning, and it looks like somebody spray painted this on what looks to be like what I'm assuming is the kingdom, just because of the bricks. It's kind of hard to tell because it's dark, but whoever is putting it out here is definitely like a Savior. And what I'm thinking is that they're probably just putting it, you know, spray painting signs, like warning signs, all over, you know, the communities, just to kind of scare them into saying that, you know, you guys aren't going to be in charge of us that much longer, we still are Negan, you know, we want to go back to our old lifestyle. Not all the Saviors, but obviously, you know, there are going to be some troublemakers that are Saviors. So I'm sure this is what this episode is going to be focusing a lot on, those Saviors that are, you know, putting out warning signs. And maybe the group is going to be trying to figure out who's doing this, because they need to, you know, deal with them and, you know, tell them that, you know, we're not going back to Negan's way, we're doing it our way. Now, the writer for episode 3 is Channing Powell, who's written a lot of episodes for The Walking Dead. She's been writing since season 4. She's wrote, you know, Internment, Inmates. Some episodes she's written recently was, in season 8, was The Damned, The Monsters, The Key. So she's been writing a lot for The Walking Dead. And the director is Dan Liu, who's only directed one other episode in The Walking Dead, and that was season 8, where he directed some guy. But he has directed a Fear the Walking Dead episode, A Good Out Here, which was in season 4. So that is the writer and director for episode 3, which is titled Warning Signs. Now, episode 4 is titled The Obliged, and it is written by Geraldine Inoa, and I believe she is a new writer for the show, but it is directed by Rosemary Rodriguez, who has directed 2 episodes. She's directed Sing Me a Song, which was a Carl and Negan episode. Great episode. I really, really did like that one. Probably one of my favorites of season 7. And then she also directed The Damned, which was last season. And I believe it was the second or third. I think it was the second episode. So she's returning to direct this episode. But moving on to episode 5. So episode 5 is where it gets pretty crazy, because as we all know, this season, Andrew Lincoln is leaving the show. Now, we don't know if that means it's going to be a death for Rick or an open-ended exit for Rick. But episode 5 was the last episode that Rick was seen filming. Andrew Lincoln was seen filming. Now, he was supposedly going to be in 6 episodes. So we don't know if that means it's going to be a little bit in episode 6, or it's going to be like a flashback during the season or something. But episode 5 was the big episode that he was supposedly going to be, leaving. And episode 5 is titled What Comes After. Now, I love this title because, you know, What Comes After is such, you know, I mean, it says a lot. And I'm sure what a lot of fans are thinking is, you know, what comes after Rick? Because, like I said, you know, this is going to probably be Rick's exit episode or something. And the fact that Greg Nicotero is directing it proves that even further. Because, like I said in the beginning of this video, Greg Nicotero always directs the episodes that are huge, either the mid-season finales or the finales or premieres. Even though this is just like a regular episode 5, which usually isn't that big in The Walking Dead, you know, The Walking Dead does get a lot of shit sometimes for, you know, not doing big stuff in the middle of the season. So the fact that they would do something like this in the middle of the season shows that they're changing that. And then also, you know, Greg Nicotero directing this proves that this is going to be, you know, maybe one of the biggest episodes of all time. And probably is going to be the biggest episode of all time if it is Rick Grimes' exit. So, you know, they want somebody to step in who has experience directing big episodes. And Greg Nicotero is that person. So the writer for this episode is Matthew Negrete, who also is a really well-known writer for The Walking Dead. And he's been writing since season 4. And something interesting about this guy is that Angela Kang, I remember she had an interview on The Talking Dead where she said that Matthew Negrete is like her right-hand man when it comes to the writing staff. So, you know, her being the showrunner makes sense why she would, you know, want Matthew to write this this episode, this big, huge episode that might be Rick's exit on The Walking Dead, because he has written some really big episodes. Some in particular are The First Time Again in season 6. He wrote the season finale in season 6, Last Day on Earth. He wrote The First Day of the Rest of Your Life. He wrote Wrath, which was the season 8 finale. So he has written a lot of big episodes for The Walking Dead. So it makes sense why, you know, he would be the one writing a big episode like this. So the title, the writer, and the director of this episode, and the rumors revolving this episode all leads me to believe that this might be the episode that we lose our famous Rick Grimes. What Comes After. But let's move on to episode 6, because for some weird reason, episode 6 hasn't been titled yet. We have the writer and the director, but we just have no title. And again, the rumors revolving around this episode is that this episode is going to be the second time jump. So maybe the title is going to be like a spoiler or something, because essentially, you know, if episode 5 is going to be Rick's last episode, you know, after Rick is like a whole new chapter for The Walking Dead. So it makes sense why, you know, episode 6 could be like a title related to like a time jump or something. So maybe that's going to be a spoiler, and they didn't really want to give that away, so that's why it's not revealed yet. But also, What Comes After, which is the last episode's title, that's also like a kind of a good title for like a time jump, almost. Because think about it, like what comes after, like what comes after Rick, you know, cough cough the whispers. But you know, seriously though, like I think What Comes After is also like could be a good title for like a time jump, because a lot of people are also saying that the time jump's going to be happening the same exact episode Rick leaves, so it's going to be happening during episode 5. But I think it'll be a little weird if like something happens to Rick and then the next scene we come back from commercial break and then we're like 6 years in the future. I feel like that's going to be super weird, so I don't think that's going to happen. I mean, it could, but I just think it's going to be a little weird. So for me, it makes most sense that episode 6 is going to be like a whole new start for The Walking Dead, and it's going to jump into the future. And then maybe that's why the title hasn't been revealed yet, because it's going to be a spoiler. Also, the title could be like a whisper spoiler, who knows, because episode 6 is when that whispers are supposedly going to come to the show. Because remember, each trailer for The Walking Dead has the first 6 episodes, like the footage from the trailers for The Walking Dead have the first 6 episodes in it, and we did see the whisper tease at the end. So maybe, you know, this episode title is going to be like related to the Whispers. I mean, even though they've confirmed the Whispers, maybe they don't want to reveal what episodes they come in. So I feel like the reason this is untitled is going to be a spoiler. But that being said, the writer for this episode is Eddie Gazillion, who wrote two episodes last season. He wrote Dead or Alive Or and Still Gotta Mean Something. And the director is Larry Tang, who directed one episode last season, and that was Time for After. So that is the writer and the director for this episode, but the title is untitled. Now, episode 7 is titled Stradivarius, which I'm pretty sure is like some type of violin type instrument. So I'm not sure exactly what this is related to The Walking Dead, but it is episode 7, and a lot of stuff are going to be changing, you know, from episode 6 or 5, 6, 7, and 8. So, but the interesting thing this episode is that Michael Cudlitz is going to be directing it. As we all know, Michael Cudlitz played Abraham in The Walking Dead, and he is going to be directing this episode, which is very exciting. And the writer is Vivian Say. I probably said that name wrong, but I believe she is a new writer to the show as well. But episode 7 is titled Stradivarius. And on to the mid-season finale move, and that is titled Evolution. Now, that is one badass title if you ask me, and I love that title. And I believe this episode is going to be like, you know, something related like hugely with the Whispers, because I'm sure they want to leave it off, you know, I'm sure they want to leave off the mid-season finale with something that's amazing and, you know, hooks us into the next half season. So I think something crazy that would be awesome for this episode is that maybe Alpha shows up. But Evolution, man, that sounds like an awesome title, so I cannot wait for it. Now, the writer for this episode is David Leslie Johnson, who I talked about early on. He also wrote episode 2, The Bridge, and like I said, he is a pretty well-known writer because he's been writing on the show for a while now. But the director is Michael Satrazimis, who he directs a lot of big episodes also. You know, he directs a lot of mid-season finales. Like, he directed last season's mid-season finale, How It's Gotta Be, which was the big Carl episode. But a huge episode he directed was The Grove, which was the Look at the Flowers episode. So this guy is a pretty well-known director for The Walking Dead 2 and Fear the Walking Dead. So he directs some pretty huge episodes. So I'm excited for him to be directing this episode. And I think episode 8 is going to be a huge episode. And I'm sure it will be, because it's a mid-season finale for the season 9. And I can't wait to see, you know, the Whispers. And I'm sure this episode is going to be like hugely Whisperer based. But those are the 8 episode titles for the first half of season 9. And it was really cool how they released all the titles for the first half, minus that 6th episode, because I'm sure it's going to be like a spoiler or something for the Whispers, or maybe like a time jump or something. So maybe that's why they haven't released it. But really cool how they released the titles and the writers and the directors, because I am very excited for season 9. And some of these titles are really cool. But I'm going to wrap it up there. But in the comments down below, you be sure to leave your thoughts and opinions on these titles and what you look forward to in season 9. And I hope you guys did enjoy this video. And if you did, be sure to leave a like rating. And for daily Walking Dead videos, be sure to hit the subscribe button. And before I finish, I quickly want to say happy birthday to Andrew Lincoln. Yes, it is his birthday today, Mr. Rick Grimes. We love him as Rick Grimes. I am a little sad that he's leaving the role, but who knows? You know, he could come back one day. But regardless, I am excited for his future and to see what other stuff he's going to be in, because he is one hell of an actor. So quickly wanted to say that. Happy birthday, Mr. Andrew Lincoln. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. It's been All Things Film. Until next time, peace.